the innocent, like the innocents that died in the pub bombings in November 1974.
Some tragedies are firmly installed on the hard drive of a nation's soul, recalled, commemorated, replayed, so all those who are old enough can always say where they were that day. Others have to fight for recognition, with those most damaged on an impossible mission to let the ambivalent see their scars. Any disaster will leave its mark. Deliberate massacre leaves images so stark as to stalk us all our days. My accent tells you where I'm from, and my heart remains in Birmingham. November 21st, 1974. Some recall it instantly, to most it means nothing at all. To us, it's when innocent people were blown limb from limb or through brick walls, their remains sprawled among rubble and electric cables or impaled by sections of mangled tables with a massive crater smashed into the concrete floor. The stench of burning flesh, the blood and gore. My eldest sister was in town that night. At just 25, still older than many who died. She got lucky with a change of plan and didn't go to the tavern in the town, unlike 18-year-old Maxine, who arrived at the scene seconds before the blast and was walking right past the device as it spewed destruction into the night. The average age of fatalities in the tavern was under 23. How can it be that such a tragedy should evade the psyche of the masses who still hold vigils on national TV for victims of other tragedies? 21 lost their lives. Others were left blind or paralysed, and in order to calm the baying mob, 6 men arrested and forced to confess through torture, beatings, mock executions, cigarette burns inflicted by uniformed yobs to the shame of Britain. 6 men convicted through withheld evidence, deeply flawed forensics from a man named Stoops, and the refusal to let the jury see the written confessions, which were full of contradictions. The identities of the killers were known to the authorities long before the roof caved in on official insistence on the guilt of the 6. None of them faced justice. The cowards who used the code word double X but didn't give specifics as to where the bombs would explode next are morally insolvent. No cause, no wars can ever absolve them. But subsequent events, the cover-up and pretense which left 6 men to do their time, was another heinous crime against the people of Brom, which trampled on the dignity of victims as surely as did the murderous scum. Brummies have made less noise than some others in injustice to sisters and brothers and the laying of their ghosts. But when it comes to injury, the quiet ones are often hurting most. Thank you.